Well, hello there again, my YouTube friends. I've got a new segment today, but I don't have this segment very often. In fact, I'm not even sure I've had one before. So this might be my first and last postbag. Anyway, I've got some stuff delivered, so I thought I'd open it on camera so you can see what I've got. They're just things I've ordered, and they've all turned up at once, so I thought I'd do a postbag on them. So the first thing, I've had a look in here already, because I wasn't sure what it was. So I'll show you what they are. And I just thought these were quite interesting and handy things to have, especially for doing 18650, anything to do with 18650s batteries. So I bought a load of these things, which are holders. For 18650, so you can build up cells or battery banks if you like. They all lock together, and these come in all different sort of lengths. You can get them in twos, threes, fours, fives, I believe, so you can build big blocks of batteries out of them. I actually thought I'd only ordered 20, but it seems, I'd have to check on my order, it seems I've got 40. Now maybe I did press 2 on the order form. These were just off eBay. But those are pretty neat, and the 18650s just, I've only got a couple of them handy, but they just slide in like so, and then say they were in like this. Put them on top and you build a little battery bank up of however big you want. If I was to join all these together, I'd probably end up with something the size of a car battery. But that's not the plan. They're just for any time I might want these. So that's the first thing. The second thing you can probably already see is these things, and you see the third thing as well, I'll open this in a minute, are similar to these for opening iPhones and phones, etc. The only difference is these ones, the standard type you get, these are really handy because they're so thin and flexible for opening screens and well, anything that's got a bezel really. But as you can see, they are quite flexible and they can be bent out of shape. I saw these ones and saw that they were made out of stainless steel, and going by the pictures they looked a bit more substantial. So let's have a look, and you can tell by the thickness compared to those, they are far more substantial. And the good thing about them is at the very ends they're sort of razor sharp. At the ends, they're not actually cut you sharp, but they are very sharp, and they're really, really strong. This part of it is also for, I haven't got an actual case of a phone knocking around. Oh yes, I have. One full of bits here. Say you had, this is just an old phone I'm putting together. So you had an iPhone like so. I believe this, you can put these just in the side there and use it as a sort of a locking clip if you like. So once you've got one side of the phone open, you can sort of lock it in there, keep that like that, and go around it with another section, with another tool on another section of the screen, which is handy. And you've also got another razor type tool at the other end. At the ends, the tools are very similar thicknesses. I think these flexible ones are still a fraction thinner, but they're not going to bend and deform. That one is certainly not going to bend and deform like those. So they're just a bit more robust, and I got two of them. These are just off Banggood. Are they off Banggood? Yes, I bought them off Banggood. These weren't supplied. I just purchased these because I saw them and I thought they looked handy. So that's those. I'll just get rid of all my rubbish now. I've done a few iPhones, look. So I need to keep that screen because it's a good screen, that. Well, a good test screen anyway. Okay, so that's that. And we'll use this tool to open this bag. Now, I think I know what's in here. In fact, can you tell what's in here? Have a guess. You've got 10 seconds. It's kind of thin. It's in a loop. Yeah, you probably guessed it already. I only guessed because of the shape and everything. It is some. Has that got all my details on? It now hasn't got my details on. Okay, so it is a load of wire. Oh, I've ordered the wrong ones, I think. Wire. And it's not ordinary wire. It is 60 amp wire. It's a bit overkill. Let me just try these things, these lugs. Did I get the right ones, or did I get ones that are far too big? Yeah, I got ones that were far too big. They can be crimped down, but I'm going to have to order some more of them. I've got other cables for these, so I can always use them. Even if they need to go on car battery terminals, which they would actually fit on. Smaller ones, anyway. So I'll keep those, but this is, as I say, 60 amp, 12 volt cable. And it's for any heavy tests or experiments I'm doing, because I've got a power supply over here that is, let me just disconnect you guys, this one here, which is 40 amp. It's 40 volt and 40 amp, this one. I've not really used it much since I've had it. I've had it about, well, maybe, I don't know, 12 months. And I've only used it a couple of times. But it's a 40 amp unit, which is pretty nice, especially for doing, you know, high current type experiments. Not necessarily voltage. They do different voltages in those power supplies. They do 80 volt, 20 amp, 40 volt, 40 amp, and a few different varieties. I just thought the 40 and 40 was a good size supply to get, because my other supplies can supply 5 and 10 amps, you know, etc. So yeah, that's 10 meters of that. And we'll move on to this one now, which is a hobby knife. I've got knives already, but I thought this one looked interesting because it might have some more control. And this is, I bought this from Banggood as well. So this is a little knife set called Our Deer. This was also purchased from Banggood. And I bought this one because, nothing to do with the case or the blades or anything, I actually like these. I've got quite a few similar grip screwdrivers for iPhone repair and stuff. But I like the stumpy sort of grip, if you like. And also this one's got a rubber grip and a twizzly top. And it's got the same blade inserts as all the other knives, which is similar to these normal, you know, hobby knives, which I use all the time. I just fancied a change over to this one to see how he was in comparison. So we'll put a blade in because we can, and they fit. They're just the same. There's like a collet you fit on with, and you tighten that up, and then you've got a nice little blade. They're for cutting round. These blades are for you know, use them for cutting round, you know, the underfill around ICs and stuff like that on iPhones, to get the chips off. There's a few various blades in there, you can see, that come with the kit, which is pretty handy. Even though these aren't supplied by Banggood, I will put links underneath to this stuff if you do want to get yourself some. So yeah, may as well just leave that like that now. I'll have to get some sort of end to put over there, because you can't just leave them out, and I can't be bothered, you know, leaving them like that all the time, because that's not great, having that sticking out the end. In fact, I'm not going to leave that like that. I'm going to put it back in there, because knowing me, you know, I'll grab the box, forget about it, and end up getting stabbed or something. So yeah, that's that kit. It's a nice little kit. I like the feel of that. It's got good weight. It's only aluminium. That's light aluminium. That, it's not heavy grade. Like, these are quite heavy aluminium. This is probably hollow, I would imagine. Nice little screwdriver type knife though, so I'll enjoy using that. Next on the list, what else did I get? Oh, this. Now I think I know what this is. I'm not 100% because I've got a few different things. I might make another unpacking, unboxing type video if anybody's interested in them. I don't normally do them, but you know, if anyone likes them, I will do them. Yeah, that's what I thought it was, a little scale. I saw one of these on the internet the other day for you know, just for weighing smaller things. I've got all, you know, the usual type of scales for, you know, shipping stuff when I need to ship stuff. But I saw one of these and I thought I'll get myself one, because I always fancied one of these for smaller items. So I picked one up. I think it was only £4 or something like that. Get off. See, we always get some sort of electronics in the show, guys, but a static electricity there. I hope he's got plastic over the front, because he looks a bit minging there. Yeah, I think it has. I can see it's got like a dull finish on it, so yeah, he's got a little plastic cover on. So let's put his batteries in, make sure he works. I'll get into these in a minute. He's not very secure in there. Let's do a modification. Oh, that's why the spring was sticking round behind one of the... Someone had reduced the effective length of the spring. It was trapped behind there somewhere. And we have a nice little lit up scale. Okay guys, I've just come back and I've just tidied up the bench a little bit here, just to get rid of the bags and the boxes and that. So we're gonna have a little game with my new scale. I'm gonna guess the weight, play guess the weight with that, and another item I've got out of shot here, which I'll definitely win the game on, but you guys will as well. So okay, so this thing, you've got a piece of solid steel bar or steel hex bar with a spike on the end of it. It's just a tool I use for, you know, prying open little, or prying up chips and stuff like that. I'm going to guess and say it's steel, 20 grams. I'm going to say 20 grams. Rubbish. 12 grams. What did you guys say? I bet you said 12.4, didn't you? Okay, right. This is a piece of stainless steel, theoretically. In comparison to that, it's... I'd say it's twice as heavy. It feels about twice the weight. You see how thick it is. A bit of plastic, a couple of probably not stainless nuts and bolts, but I'm going to say, going by that, what was that? 10, 12. I'm going to say this is 38. Okay, add your guess. Ooh, 10 grams out. I've gone further away this time. Okay, second to last thing. This is a pure sheet of roll copper. Solid copper. Well, not solid copper, but it's a solid roll of copper, if you know what I mean. So I'm going to guess this is quite heavy. I need to tighten it up. That's a bit loose. So in comparison to that, I'm going to say 4 times heavier. So I'm going to say for this, 110 grams. I don't know how much it is because it's had loads of reels cut off, you know, chopped off. So 110, I'm going to say. Ooh, not too bad, I guess. So that's not bad. Right, this one, I'm going to win this side of the game. Okay, I think I know what this will be. Actually, I hope I know what this will be, because this will tell me whether the scale is accurate or not, or within a, you know, a reasonable sort of tolerance. So I thought it said 600, but it's 500 gram. Okay, so let's see how accurate he is. 501. That's not too bad. Let's just do a zero. Yeah, 501 grams. So he's 1 gram out at full range. You can get these scales that go up to 500 gram, and also I think you can get ones that go up to either 1 or 200. I just chose the 500 because you know, give more scope for different things. I've got other scales for weighing bigger stuff, but these are handy just for weighing, you know, smaller items. So I thought I'd get that one. So that's the video, guys, and that's my little haul of stuff, excluding the wire that you saw, etc. So I'll say thank you for watching, and I shall see you in the next video. Take care, guys. See you soon.